making the aluminium square. Use a Sharpie, draw a line from there to there, combination square, combination square. Two vices. This is two pieces of angle iron, and they've got these scrap pieces of aluminium at each end. Using a surf form, we work down to so easy about this method is even a blunt old surf form works really well on aluminium. Of course I'm right-handed. Let's try not to jolly anything. Let's see if we're still in focus. Yes, we are. Great, there we go. It would help if the vice was tightened. Should point out that if you buy aluminium online, usually 1 millimeter for a small chassis and for a beginner, it'll have a perfect square. The corners will be perfectly 90 degrees. Link in the description to the place that sells aluminium. So, what I need is 23 cm from there, 23 cm, right the way along, 23, tighten it up a bit, 23, 23 cm. Okay, now we get a knife, brass knife or that side just a little bit more over there. I'm satisfied with that. Next thing is we want 4.5 centimeter drops, folds for the front and back panels. Now I'm putting 4.5 centimeter from the front edge. These are going to be the folds. Normally you'd use a scribe, but you know, this is so incredibly disorganized. Can you tell me something I don't know? You're gonna have to manage with a screw, which works, seems to do the purpose effectively. And that end as well, there you go, from there to there, there. And there, and then we it can be derived from the previous folds there and there that this was a chassis that worked out, that was previously built by me, the reason why I've chosen this piece is that I want to demonstrate that it's possible to build using the roughest bit of aluminium you can get and still make it work. So excuse my skull bit, there we go, there and there. Scribe it. Pop that in the vise. large screwdriver and we'll do a nice deep score. Don't go, it's obviously a matter of judgment, this bit, because if you go too far, you'll end up with a weak corner, weak edge. Okay. Okay, now, rubber mallet. It's not really possible to use a hammer in this instance because it actually distorts the aluminium quite badly. Ooh, there we go. It's very hot today. I'm a sweltering bag of hooves. It's like a hoof bag with like a bag with loads of hooves inside it. And that's me, that is. That's nice. Now to the other end. Okay, so... a hoof amp. Because I haven't mentioned it just yet, this chassis is intended to become a 2x ECL86 record player amplifier. Also works with cassette and radio if you happen to put those on the input. It's the same thing as what we would have in the 1960s in a radiogram. I mean, they sounded great. I love them. Yeah, I know they're not hi-fi, but who gives a damn? They sound great. I love them when they were there. So, there we go. We're folding that now. So, that little trick helps to straighten things out a little bit. I mean, there are two ways to do this. This is the cheap way, because not everyone is prepared to pay up for a metal folding machine. Now, I'm also say to people that working with aluminium, it can be dangerous. Now, what I've just done there is I've just snatched this sharp on the corner. So that's one of the things. Just need to be careful. I mean, anything you do is going to involve some risk. This is 1mm aluminium, and using this method of building chassis, this will probably be about the thickest that you could probably go, 1mm. But it's fine for a small, 2x ECL86 amplifier. Let's just check that for how straight the thing is. Okay, take that. Don't take it out. Don't lose it. Okay. There you go. Like that. So, I mean, obviously, if this chassis is not really, really totally square, and you start out, okay. Like we're doing, I mean, it'll still work. The amplifier will still work and sound quite good. Okay, it would look very nice, really. And of course, the whole point of building electronic equipment as a hobby is it's got to look nice. You know, I mean, anyone can do a bodge job and broken bit here and bent bit here, but you know, it's nice to do a job that looks good when you finish. checking for front to backness accuracy. Front to backness. Yeah, that's within acceptable limits. So the next thing after this is to give it a good old clean up in the sink and bring, you know, nicer, polish it, you know, well, not polish, polish. You could polish it, but giving it a good wipe down and get all the marks off, that would be a really nice thing to do. Then we can start thinking about where we want the transformers and the valves. Okay, see you later.
Step ladder, stick it there, so.